morning. Please rise and join the class of 2010 as we honor our country. The national anthem will be played by the Beech Grove High School Band under the direction of Mr. Corey Wynn. Class officers, please come forward.
Hello and welcome to the graduation ceremony of the class of 2010. We'd like to thank all the family and friends for joining us today on this very special day.
On the stage, we have Dr. Paul Kaiser, superintendent. We have Dr. Tom Keeley, director of business and personnel. Mr. Rick Skirvin, school board president. Ms. Janice King, school board vice president. Mr. Steve Cox, principal. Mr. Randy Levenger, the vice principal. Mr. Carmen Hurley, the vice principal. Mrs. Karen Matthews, our senior class counselor. Ms. Melody Stevens, board member. Mr. Jim Hensley, a board member. Mr. Tim Luttrell, board member. Ms. Nancy Mobley, a board member. And Ms. Beth Brennan, another board member.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce our speakers today. These three students have worked very hard over the last 4 years in their careers to earn the honor to speak to you today. The president of the class of 2010 is Mr. Kyle Cruz. Kyle is the son of Tom and Sheila Cruz. Kyle plans to attend the University of Indianapolis and major in human biology.
Hello. How about that right in? Guess that's why I call it Sin City. I'm Kyle Cruz, proud class president, and I cordially welcome you to this significant event. I never thought how hard to nearly impossible it was going to be to write a well-written graduation speech. I was oblivious to all the ideas that would run around in my head fighting one another to be put down on the paper. So instead, I thought I would put things into statistical perspective. Graduates, We have only known Beach Grove High School for the last 4 years. Mostly all of us 17 to 18 years old. So that means we have been in high school for 20% of our lives. As we really can't recall the very first years of our childhood, which means it's closer to 30% of our lives. Averaging 6 hours a night of sleep, 8 hours a day of school, which means 44% of the time we are awake has been spent in school, not including the weekends and extracurricular activities. For the past 4 years, we have roughly repeated this schedule 40 out of the 52 weeks of the year, 77% of the time, meaning that 34% of those years were meant to be spent at Beach Grove High School, approximately 10% of our member pass, 7% of our lives a day, and 1.6 of a projected lifespan of 85 years, but of which 100% was a gratifying and uplifting experience. I would like to thank Luke Terrell for these unneeded statistics. My point is that Beach Grove High School has given us so much. It has helped us build character who we are today. Graduates, I know you remember the first day of high school, or at least I do. I was 5'6", 130 pounds, and I think we all felt a little out of place. I saw myself surrounded by the world of everything, and I felt like nothing. I mean, of course, I had it easier than others. I had a senior brother to introduce me to all the senior ladies and show me who the coolest teacher were, like Mr. Anslett with his 8-hour candy store from the $1 No Holla down to the East Side Specials. Coming into high school, we had no idea we would spend the last 4 years on Facebook, listening to music, and performing the newest dance craze. Our parents unknowingly tried to show us the error of our ways by doing the Running Man, the Roger Rabbit, and the Robot. But of course, as of us being all-knowing, selective hearing young adults, we fell victims to the power of dance. For the past 4 years, we've spent our time two-stepping down the halls, walking in and out and not bothering to walk it back, using our whole body to perform the cleanest dance move ever created, Stanky Leg, and moving side to side by doing the Soulja Boy at every dance, party, any convocation that we all collaborated. As we ended our last year at Beach Grove High School, we finished strong by jerking our way to graduation. Now parents, I promise you, it is a dance. No need to be alarmed while your students have been jerking for the last 8 months. But on a much serious more note, as we sit here and get recognized for the completion of our high school education, I think it is imperative that we remember today does not mark the end of our educational development, but yet serves as another step in our life journey, reaching for the sky, knowing that the sky is the limit. When I heard these first words spoken by the greatest rapper alive, Lil Wayne, they hit home. They stuck with me for years. Until one day at football practice, when I heard a coach say, "Don't tell me the sky is the limit when there are footprints on the moon." As we move forward into life, we now face economical challenges locally, nationally, and globally. I'm nervous. The opportunities are fewer and demands are greater. In order to achieve success, both personally and professionally, we must embrace education as a never-ending process, not as an accomplishable act. The globalization of our economy has brought many challenges and possibilities to our doorstep. We face dangers both domestically and abroad that our men and women fight bravely each and every day. Globalization has also raised the bar with respect to competition. The opportunities are limitless, but the need for education and personal development are at an all-time high. We are just not competing with the people from our towns, cities, or even states. We are competing with all of our fellow citizens and even peers around the world. Hard to believe, Indiana is only slightly above the national average for percentage of students entering college that will graduate. As the next class to begin our collegiate journey, we must challenge ourselves to improve upon this statistic. We have the opportunity to pursue education not only for better ourselves, but also our communities. We as a class have accomplished so much. We have started traditions at Beechwolf High School that will last for years. But we haven't arrived here alone. Let's not forget the people who helped us. We must recognize all of those who have contributed to our success thus far, to our parents, advisors, teachers, and coaches. Thank you for your support and guidance and encouragement that you've provided us along our journeys. You have contributed greatly to our development, and we appreciate that. And I ask you that you continue to support us in the path that we choose to follow. Class, I believe school has helped us more than just educationally. It has been the strength of our social life. Now, if you met your best friend in the summer before freshman year, to finding a lifelong friendship during senior winter break, there's no doubt in my mind that the memories and relationships that we made at Beechwolf High School will be life-lasting. When it all comes to an end, we have had a fair share of successes and failures throughout high school. But we can always say that we have grown as individuals and set ourselves for success. I hope everyone will look back at the time at Beechgrove and with a sense of pride of your accomplishments and a contentment with your decisions and an eagerness to take what Beechgrove has taught us and face the world. I wish everybody the best of luck, whether you choose college, work, or a military-based path. I would like to leave you with one final word of advice. You have come very far. We all have. Your parents are very proud of you and what you have accomplished. You have every right to walk with confidence and exuberance. Later today, when your parents shed that very first tear after graduation, this would be the best, without a doubt, most prime opportunity time to ask for money. Thank you.
The salutatorium, the class of 2010, is Ryan Cloy. Ryan is the son of Tonda Neal. Ryan is graduating with a grade point average of 4.25. Ryan plans to attend Wabash College and major in biochem. Ryan Cloy.
Class of 2010, enjoy the power and the beauty of your youth. You will not understand the power and beauty of your youth until they have faded. In his speech, Everyone is Free to Wear Sunscreen, Baz Luhrmann speaks about many important aspects of life. And today, I hope to do the same with his help. Before we go our separate ways, I'd like to say a few words. If you take nothing else from today, keep these three things. Remember who you were, reflect on who you are, and think about who you will one day become. Self-reflection is the best way to take whatever good you can from the negativity of your life. And there is much good to be taken from today. The day we've all been waiting for the past 13 years. The day that marks the start of our futures. Commencement Day. Over the past 13 years, we've gotten to know each other. Now, that doesn't mean that we always like each other, but we do know each other pretty well. Our time together is more important than any differences that we may have. We all have an unbreakable bond. No matter what happens, we all have the past 13 years in common. Each person that walks across this stage today will remember something different. Some will remember sports, others music, And still for others, it will simply be hanging out with friends. Whether it's winning sectionals 2 years ago or the band's state appearance this past year, each of our memories will remain with us and define how we think of high school. These common memories are the key to who we are as a group and are a vital part of who we are as individuals. We are all brought together by the past 13 years, even if there's not always a strong social connection between some of us. The trials and tribulations that we have faced throughout school bring us together, from the most athletic football player, to the most talented musician, to the geekiest science nerd. The past 13 years have made us who we are and will continue to shape us for years to come. Going out to a movie with friends, staying in and studying alone, or listening intently to current news from Mr. Mails. They act as a common thread that connects each of us to each other. While we rely strongly on what has been, we must open our eyes to learn from what is and look forward with great expectation to what will be. We'll all soon go our separate ways. For some, basic training and a military career lie ahead, and others will soon be freshmen all over again. No matter where life takes us, no matter where we end up, we each have that same common experience to hold on to. For those of you who are still unsure of your future, Mr. Luhrmann advises you to not feel guilty if you don't know what to do with your life. He recalls that the most interesting people he knows didn't know at 22 what they wanted to do with their lives, and that some of the most interesting 40-year-olds that he knows still don't. Unfortunately, I can't say for certain what lies ahead for each of us. I can, however, tell you that your family and friends will be there beside you. Your friends that are here around you now, your other siblings to guide you, and of course, Mom, always looking to embarrass you like you're 8 years old again. These people in your lives, the people who have filled this room to watch you, these people will continue to be in your lives to help you up when you fall, to give you a shoulder to cry on, or to give you the extra push when you just want to quit. Mr. Luhrmann recommends to get to know your parents. You never know when they'll be gone for good. Be nice to your siblings. They are the best link to your past and the ones most likely to stick with you in the future. Understand that friends come and go, but for the precious few, you should hold on. Class of 2010, congratulations. Our achievements are many, and if I do say so myself, our future is quite bright. Always remember who you were yesterday, reflect on who you are today, and think about who you will be tomorrow. We have much to be proud of. With that sense of pride, the power of self-reflection, and the strength of our common experience, I wish you nothing but the very best this life has to offer. Thank you.
Valedictorian of the class of 2010 is Brittany Typen. Brittany is the daughter of Daniel and Raquel Typen. Brittany is graduating with a grade point average of 4.26, and Brittany plans to attend the University of Indianapolis and major in biology and pre-med. Brittany Typen.
Legacy, a collection of thoughts and ideas left behind for the world to accept and cherish. No matter what the future holds, our legacy leaves a trail of footprints of where we have been and to whom we have influenced. Whether it's on the football team, in the science lab, or even within the walls of Steak and Shake, a piece of each of us is left behind, which eventually builds a portfolio, a legacy. They can be pieces of our humor, such as a witty joke about calculus, pieces of our dependability, such as always paying for lunch for every single person at our table, or they can be pieces of who we are. Smiles, strong handshakes, giggles, mistakes, failed actions, and consequences that each build upon our expanding legacy. At this point in our lives, our legacy is like an iPod shuffle. Yes, it contains our favorite songs, but nothing compared to what an iTouch can hold. These past 12 years barely make a dent on the experiences we will have. There are some of you who refuse to give up your hold on this legacy. Friends, I encourage you to step forward and allow each and every one of your legacies to flourish. Thankfully, God is gracious, and we each have a second chance. After today, we begin anew, and we sing a new song. Our legacies are fresh as sweet citrus, and the new dawn of tomorrow calls our names. The future may forever seem impending and frightening, but we each carry the legacy of our past. This legacy gives you a starting point to base where we should set our standards, morals, and opinions. Each of us has witnessed the best of our closest and dearest companions. Their success and failure remind each of us what it takes to have a legacy that makes an impact. Still, our closest companions can enlighten us on our own improvements. Looking back, you might see a legacy full of procrastination, or maybe a legacy overflowing with late-night barbecues, overdue road trips, and days full of the sun and the earth's beauty. But as your legacy thrives, remember to be thankful. Mothers will attest, and so will your teachers, that a simple thank you is more than enough for their years of putting up with you. Saying thank you is the smallest gift that will make the biggest difference in their lives. Appreciating others will never be underestimated when this discipline is applied. While being grateful, notice that this world seems to be made for the most competitive. Only the strongest and the most fit seem to survive. As part of the species Homo sapien, we select and honor the best and the brightest. But the appreciation for everyone in society sets the species apart. Humans alone are able to love beyond the capacity of all other creatures. This capacity to love one another will be our greatest strength. When each of us steps into the world, our ability to love and appreciate one another will set us apart from other individuals. As you journey on the narrow path, remember to always love. Not with words and tongue, but with actions and in truth. Allow love to rain down on your fellow man. Society keeps telling us to act only for our own benefit, but don't. The truth of always loving your neighbor will never go out of style. The rules of society do not have to be mastered in order to survive on this planet. Remember that right and wrong will always be right and wrong. No matter what other people may believe, or what they say, the truth will always be the truth. Remember that you make your own legacy, and regardless of what society may call the truth, you are the one able to decide. Make your legacy your own. By building your own legacy day by day, don't forget to dream, to laugh, to love, and to appreciate all that this world has to offer. I only hope that your feet will be steadfastly planted on the path of truth and your heart set firmly on solid ground. Never forget the legacy you are leaving behind for others to cherish and emulate. Ultimately, I hope you dance. I hope your routine to life's music will put you through the most depressing moments and lift you up to soar high on wings like eagles. I hope you find life's partner to guide you on this waltz through time and space. I hope you dance.
Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2010 has earned a variety of honors and scholarships. Awards of which I was aware before the print date are listed in the commencement program you have before you this morning. At this time, I would like to recognize students for honors not awarded at our honors night earlier this month. These students will receive their awards from Dr. Kaiser and Mr. Clevenger when they pass across the stage to receive their diplomas. Students, when I call your name, please stand and remain standing. I would like the audience to please hold their applause until all students have been recognized. Zachary Abbott, Kyra Andrews, Kelly Boyle, Brandon Brinkley, Kayla Brown, Ashley Berkman, Lindsay Butler, Ryan Cloyd, Noelle Conaway, Dustin Corbin, Kyle Cruz, Austin Zapp, Eric Danz, Andrew Davis, Sevi Duncan, Sarah Dunn, Allison Durbin, Stacy Hall, Jeremiah Hanlon, Nicholas Hodges, Scott Lewis, Zachary Luttrell, Christopher Parker, Samantha Peavy, Melora Reed, Patrick Stogsdill, Brittany Typen, Jasmine Thomas, Brittany Utterback, and Jean Widman. Congratulations. Each member of the class of 2010 who earns an academic honors diploma will receive a $100 scholarship from Beech Grove High School for his or her achievement, along with an academic honors diploma pin. Several members of the class of 2010 plan to serve our country in the armed forces after graduation. Students, as I call your name, please remain standing. Again, please hold your applause until all students have been recognized. Vincent Davis, U.S. Navy. Alicia Eland, Air Force Reserve Officer Training Corps. Evan Fisher, U.S. Air Force. Eli Jarrett, U.S. Navy. Jordan King, U.S. Air Force. Russell Schaub, U.S. Air Force. Aaron Hsu, U.S. Marine Corps. Zachary Vaughn, U.S. Marine Corps. Bryce Weathers, U.S. Air Force. And Zachary Williams, U.S. Air Force.
Before I address the graduating class, I'd like to make the following announcements. Thanks again to Mr. Nguyen and the band for the pre-commencement music. This commencement exercise is going to be videotaped by Mr. Tim Showalter and will be aired during the month of June on Channel 28 here in Beech Grove. A copy of the all-in-one senior video and the commencement program may be ordered either in the gym lobby this morning or at the high school front office. It's a cost of $22, and that includes the shipping if you want that done. Each of you, over the past 4 years, have created memories that will last a lifetime. Those memories may have been through academic endeavors, athletics, band, choir, clubs, or even the fine arts productions. As I reflect back over the past 4 years, I think of several success stories. The achievements of the Science Olympiad team and the Brain Game team and the academic team this year. And I'm very proud of the math team that who scored and placed third in the Class 2 state meet at Purdue University. Athletically, I think about the football team, the exciting victory over Heritage Christian this year. I have very fond memories, too, of the boys basketball team in 2008 winning the sectional, which hadn't been done for 16 years that some of you were involved in. And of course, the girls golf team this year winning the sectional title, which is the first time in school history. Your class has been part of numerous ICC championships in boys and girls basketball, girls golf, and wrestling. And several of you individually have reached personal bests in your individual sports that you've been involved in. In the Fine Arts Department, I think of the number of times we placed first, either at the ICC Art Show or the outstanding artifacts that we have on display when we go to the Beech Grove City School Art Show. And we do that on an annual basis. You've done that for 4 years. And your class is making their mark in Beech Grove. You are setting a tradition. You are the first class that we're going to start the tradition of displaying your artwork on the hallways in the art room hallway. In the music department, I remember the excellent performances of the choirs at the Sophomore Invitationals and the ISSMA competitions. Matter of fact, this year the choir received so many points that they were awarded with distinction for their performances. And I'll always remember the tremendous spring spectaculars that you've been involved in. This year, or last year, we did iTunes, My Playlist. This year, it was Glee, Hornet Avenue versus meets Broadway. And of course, all the musicals and the drama performances that you've been involved in over the last 4 years. And of course, the marching band placing fifth this past fall in the Class C state finals, which ties the record for Beech Grove. And that was the first time anything that is like that's occurred in 19 years. And I will always remember this year's Hornet Camp, when we went down to Flat Rock, YMCA, and we had a great time. That was a special time. Through your involvement in these activities, you've experienced special moments and have developed friendships and relationships that with your peers that are going to be lifelong. As seniors, been very key in the continuing to make Beech Grove High School a special place to go to school. Your leadership and involvement has continued to create a school of high expectation, high achievement, a safe environment, and a place where people care about the individual. I appreciate your leadership and your input in developing the senior courtyard and the way that you've embraced that, the responsibility of maintaining it that this year and also to improve that area. I definitely appreciate that. Several of you have been role models, both at school and in the community of Beech Grove. And I'm very proud of the number of you that have been seniors that have engaged in extracurricular and co-curricular activities and all the activities that go on outside of school to do the extra things for excellence. Congratulations goes out to the 49 of you who received the Triple H Award earlier this month. And as you leave Beech Grove High School and you transition to the workforce or for the vocational career, or to continue your higher education opportunities, I'll give you the advice that my father gave me when I headed to Purdue University too many years ago to remember. But there are 5 steps to success. First one is to look someone in the eye when you're speaking to them. The second one is to shake hands with a firm grip. The third is to be honest. The fourth is to have a positive attitude and remember to smile. And the fifth is, you know what's right from wrong, just do the right thing. The class of 2010, remember that you'll always have a home. It is Beech Grove High School. Have a safe journey as you leave these halls, go out in the world and make your mark in Godspeed. Thank you. And now the class of 2010, will you please rise? Dr. Paul Kaiser, Superintendent of Beech Grove City Schools, and Mr. Rick Skirvin, President of the Board of Education, I would like to present to you the graduating class of Beech Grove High School for the year of 2010. This class has met all the requirements set forth by the Beech Grove City School Board and the State of Indiana. And it entitles them to receive their diplomas, which signifies their completion of the high school career. This class has the highest number of credits required for graduation in the state of Indiana. Dr. Paul Kaiser.
On behalf of the Board of Education, administration and staff of Beech Grove City Schools, and by the power vested in my office by the state of Indiana, I pronounce you graduates of Beech Grove High School. Good luck, and please be seated.
As we make ready for the distribution of the diplomas, we'd like the audience to cooperate with us in a few items so the process can run very smoothly. You may take photos from your seat or from the roped off area to my right. Please do not use the center aisle because the students will be coming through that center aisle. Ladies and gentlemen, each member of this graduating class is a special person. Each graduate has worked hard for 4 years to hear their name being read as they walk across this stage. To applaud or make noise for one graduate is not fair for the next one member of their class. To applaud or make noise to show show disrespect for the students and this class. The class of 2010 has worked hard to demonstrate dignity in this commencement. The class of 2010 and myself would like to ask you to show dignity to these graduates by holding your applause until all graduates have received their diploma. Then we will celebrate a lot together. Thank you for your cooperation. Will the escorts please come forward?
Kyle Anthony Cruz, Sarah Elizabeth McKenzie, Brittany Ann Typen, Amanda Noel Conaway, Ryan Adam Cloyd, Julianne Elizabeth Tutterow, Zachary Conrad Abbott, Garth Allen Spitz, Kyra Elizabeth Andrews, Andrew Charles Davis, Cody Mitchell Atherton, Sevi David Duncan, Brooklyn Nicole Baker, Casey Noel Farmer, Kelly Morgan Boyle, Bryce Edward Weathers, Kayla Jane Brown, Sarah Ann Dunn, Brandon Michael Brinkley, Eric Robert Danz, Ashley Marie Berkman, Christy Renee Showalter, Philip Nelson Davis II, Connor Hayes Law, Lindsay Faye Butler, Anna Cecilia Carrion, Taylor Colleen Cardenas, Samantha Leanne Peavy, Dakota Michael Catron, Courtney Lynn Price, Irwin Joseph Click, Allison K. Durbin, Bethany Ann Coleman, Miranda Leanne Tryon. Dustin Lee Corbin. Kevin Andrew Pence. Areli Berenice Cortez. Taylor Chantel Hall. Austin Ross Kenneth Zapp. Elise Janine Vushcollins. Tyler Michael Anderson. Zachary David Williams. Chelsea K. Davis. Cody Joe Wagner. Patrick Michael Doyle. Aaron Eli Jarrett. Alicia May Eland. Evan Wayne Fisher. Aaron Elizabeth Fennessy. Jenny May Zander. Sierra Marie Flannery. Heather Marie Stevens. Sarah Marie Fouts. Vincent Anthony Davis. Joshua Scott Lewis. Anthony Dwayne Mayer. Ashley Zavaria Goodwin. Russell Joseph Schaub. Shelby Danielle Graham. Ashley Nicole Hempel. Brittany Lynn Graves. Lauren Elizabeth Hudson. Rommel Valentino Green. Stephen Joseph Summers. Bobby Joe Hall Jr. Krista Arlene Rennick. Eric Kenneth Hamilton. Jacob Michael Hamilton. Jeremiah Wayne Hanlon. James Timothy Taylor. Glenn Aaron Harper. Kelsey Nicole Richardson. Latea Louise Harris. Jasmine Erlette Thomas. Jesse Nicole Hatley. Zachary Ross Luttrell. Michael Wayne Edward Hawkins. Aaron Michael Clue. Victoria Ray Hendrickson. Kelsey Ilona McComb. Zachary Paris Vaughn. Nicholas Donovan Hodges. Brittany Marie Heiser. Jessica Nicole McCoy. Jared Michael Holmes. Akash Bharat Patel. Kelly Elizabeth Howe. Autumn Noelle Warren. Kayla Sue Jen. Brittany Nicole Utterback. Kaylee Joe Berry. Luann Guadalupe Cano. Shayna Marie Thomasina Leatherman, Tanya Jean Renee Widman, Scott Allen Lewis, Lauren Nicole Niokas, Andrew Thomas Woods, Melora Ann Reed, Jordan David King, Aaron Wayne Hsu, Anthony Raymond Metzler, Christopher Charles Parker, Carissa Rose Powers, Natalie Rose Vargas, Rebecca Lynn Ransdale, Renee Lynn Ransdale, Emily Nicole Redman, Joshua Thomas Story, Scott Joseph Runner, Aaron Danielle Wynn, Noah Ryan Shelley, Douglas Michael Vanover, Randy Allen Troy Lagle, Deja Latish Zook, Macy Lynn Stonerock, Julianne Odessa York, John Joseph Turk, Vera Von Zavorsky, Brittany Nicole West, Courtney Lorraine Westerfield, Cletus Ray Jones III, Jessica Renee Ramage, Matthew Lucas Barger, Courtney Roxanne Michele Campbell, Stacy Ann Hall, Nicholas Ray McCaffrey Newland, Patrick Keith Stogsdill, Yun B. Song, Logan Michael Trotter,
I present you the class of 2010. Class officers, will you please return to the stage?
Graduating class of 2010, please rise.
Graduating class, please turn your tassels.
with a hawk.